In this video, I will present two examples of linear programming applications. One of them comes from marketing application, while the other one from operations management application. The first example we will look at falls into media selection for marketing. The application of linear programming in media selection is designed to help marketing managers allocate a fixed advertising budget across various advertising media, such as social media, television, internet, podcast, and radio. In this example, the company would like to know how many ads should be run on each medium in order to maximize total audience contact. Not surprisingly, there are several constraints. For example, the company decides to run at most 10 TV commercials, 20 podcast ads, and 10 social media ads. There is only a total budget of $18,200. Please stop this video here and see if you can formulate a linear programming model for this example. Some of the information is underlined here. Are you able to complete step 1, define the decision variables, state objective function, and state all constraints? The first part of step 1 involves defining the decision variables. We usually start with final outcome of this business decision problem first when we try to identify these variables. The company tries to decide the number of ads to be run on each platform. This is quite vague. Let's be more specific. One recommendation, not necessarily the optimal solution, is to run 10 ads on each of the three platforms. That means 10 TV commercials, 10 podcast ads, and 10 social media ads. Examining the format of this solution, we can tell we indeed need three variables to represent each of these three numbers. I'm going to use T to represent number of TV commercials, P for podcast ads, and S for social media ads. You can use other variable names. Just be sure to give meaningful and relevant variable names to prevent any confusion. Therefore, T, P, S are our decision variables. We can enter these lines in Lingo. Be sure to include all the necessary punctuations, such as semicolons at the end of each line and explanation marks at the beginning of each line. Moving on to the objective function. This company tries to maximize the total audience contact. We do know that each TV commercial is able to reach 100,000 viewers. Each podcast is able to reach 18,000 viewers, and each social media ad is able to reach 40,000 viewers. We will need to calculate the total viewers first before we can let our LP solver to maximize it. We know that T represents the total number of TV commercials. Each TV commercial reaches 100,000 viewers. T of them should reach 100,000 multiplied by T. We can do the same for podcast and social media as well. Summing them up would give us the total audience contact. Now, we define our objective function using max in Lingo. The last part of step 1 involves stating all the constraints. There are in fact quite a number of them in this example. Let's start with the budget constraint first. We know that the promotional budget is limited to $18,200, so we would have to calculate the total cost first and make sure this total cost would not exceed $18,200. Each TV commercial costs $2,000, podcast costs $300, and social media ad costs $600. The total cost can be calculated using 2000 multiplied by T plus 300 multiplied by P plus 600 multiplied by S. And the total cost have to be less than or equal to 18,200. We enter this line in Lingo here. There are some other constraints on the maximum media usage. For example, TV commercial and social media ads should not be more than 10 each, and a podcast should not be more than 20. These constraints can be expressed using simple mathematical inequalities. The company also wants to make sure there is a balanced use of advertising media, so podcast ads must not exceed 50% of the total number of ads authorized. Television should account for at least 10% of the total number of ads authorized. In order to set up these two constraints, we would have to express the total number of ads authorized first. That's the sum of T, P, and S. Podcast must not exceed 50% of the total ads. So P should be less than or equal to 50% multiplied by the sum. TV should account for at least 10% of the total ads. So T should be more than or equal to 0.1 multiplied by the sum. We have successfully translated the original business decision problem into a mathematical model. In step 2, we input our model into Lingo, as shown by the screenshot. The next two steps are quite straightforward. Steps 3 and 4 ask us to obtain computer printouts, interpret optimal solutions, and report optimal strategy. The optimal solution for this problem is to run 4 TV commercials, 14 podcast messages, and 10 social media ads. With this optimal strategy, the company should expect to reach 1,052,000 viewers. The next example would be a blending example under operations management applications. Blending problems are about determining an optimal mix of ingredients. For example, oil companies must determine the least costly mix of different crude oils and other chemicals to mix together in order to produce a certain grade of gasoline. Let's look at one example here. The company needs to mix 3 ingredients to develop a new additive. For proper performance, the total amount of additive must be at least 10 ounces per gallon of fuel. But for safety reasons, the amount cannot exceed 15 ounces per gallon of fuel. There are additional guidelines on mixing the 3 ingredients. Given the cost per ounce for the 3 ingredients, how should the company mix them together to produce the new additive at a minimum cost? Now, pause the video, see whether you are able to formulate this linear programming problem on your own. Give it a try. Using the hints given on the screen, are you able to set up the problem? Okay, I'm going to show you how you can do this. First, let's start with defining the decision variables. The company attempts to mix 3 ingredients in a certain way to minimize the cost of a resulting mixture. One trick that helps to identify the decision variables is try to come out with one possible strategy for this company. It does not have to be the optimal strategy at this moment yet. One possible recommendation we can give is to mix 2 ounces of A, 2 ounces of B, and 1 ounce of C. Well, you can see that we have used 3 numbers here, 2 ounces of A, and 2 for B, and 1 for C. We now generalize this strategy to a more generic strategy. That would be XA ounces of A, XB ounces of B, and XC ounces of C. So XA would represent the ounces of A, and XB for B, and XC for C. These are indeed our decision variables. We can enter these lines in Lingo. Be sure to include all the necessary punctuations, such as the semicolons at the very end, and the explanation marks at the beginning. Moving on to the objective function, we try to minimize the cost of the mixture. We do know that each ounce of A costs 10 cents, and B costs 3 cents, and C costs 9 cents. So we can calculate the total cost to be 0.1 multiplied by XA, 0.03 multiplied by XB, and 0.09 multiplied by XC, and we sum them up. We use mean in Lingo to minimize the total cost, as shown on the screen. There are several constraints in this example. For example, the total amount of additive must be at least 10 ounces per gallon of fuel. An amount of additive must not exceed 15 ounces per gallon of fuel. We sum up the total amount of 3 ingredients, make sure the total amount is more than 10, but also less than 15. We would need to use 2 equations to represent this. We were also told that at least 1 ounce of A must be used for every 1 ounce of B. This part is quite tricky. If we have 2 ounces of B in the mixture, that means XB is 2. This constraint requires that there will be at least 2 ounces of A, meaning XA would be greater than or equal to 2. Or equivalently, XA must be greater than or equal to XB. We also know that the amount of C must be greater than 1/2 of the amount of A. This part is somewhat straightforward. XC must be greater than 0.5 multiplied by XA. Now we are done with step 1. With all the decision variables defined, the objective and constraints stated clearly. Let's move on to step 2. In step 2, we input our model to LINGO, as shown by the screenshot. After clicking on the target icon or solver icon in LINGO, we obtain this printout from LINGO. The optimal solution is to mix 4 ounces of A, 4 ounces of B, and 2 ounces of C for each gallon of fuel. When we do that, the total cost can be reduced to 70 cents per gallon. I hope you found these two examples helpful. This also concludes this video.